Good morning. In the last video, we have discussed about the topic foliation. So now we are discussing on the topic lineation. So foliation and lineation are quite same in some characteristics. Foliation is the parallel arrangement of planar surface, but in lineation the subparallel to parallel alignment of linear fabric element. So it is the subparallel to parallel alignment of elongate linear fabric element within a rock body, and lineations are formed by the linear parallel arrangement of mineral either by growth or by mechanical orientation. This is the linear arrangement of mineral, or it formed by the intersection of two planar structure, that is bedding and cleavage, and it is also formed by development of silicon sites in the fault, or it formed by stretching of rock body. So a lineation is the counterpart of the foliation, that is a set of linear structure produced in a rock as a result of formation. This is a set of linear structure. Here you can see in the drinking straws. So next come to the types of lineation. So first type is your silicon side. So silicon side found in the fault, mainly found in the fault block. So fault structure showing silicon sites commonly exhibit groups or striations formed to frictional resistance, the direction of relative movement. A similar kind of lineation is found in flexure sleeve folding, where successive layers have moved one another as the fold tightens. Here successive layers are one above the another. Sorry, here you have seen the silicon side in the fault plane. So next come to the intersection lineation. Intersection lineation is produced due to intersection of two planar structure, because intersection of two plane is a line. So here is the intersection lineation, and intersection lineation is the intersection of two planar structure, and it is formed due to axial plane cleavage intersect with the bedding plane, or it is formed due to axial plane cleavage and bedding plane cleavage. Then comes to the crenulation cleavage. Crenulation cleavage is defined by small folds in the bed, and crenulation lineation is same. Crenulation cleavage found in the planar surface, but crenulation lineation found in the linear surface. So the rocks that are finely laminated undergo small scale of folding. This is your folding, this is your finely laminated crenulation lineation. Exhibit a strongly developed lineal structure due to parallel folding. It is well developed in phyllite and schist rock of metamorphic. So this is parallel layer of folding. And here you can see fold lineation or crenulation lineation. Then comes to the mineral lineation. Mineral lineation can be defined by preferred dimension orientation of inequant grains, or by elongate mineral aggregates. Here you can see hornblende lineation in orthogenesis. So mineral lineation is defined by linear arrangement of minerals in a rock. or linear arrangement of elongate mineral aggregates. So here another lineation, that is stretching lineation. It is formed by deformation of pre-existing object and defined by elongate mineral aggregates like an elongated collection of quartz crystal that together define a long stretched pebble of quartz. Next come to the wood. So in mineral lineation, hornblende crystals have a long dimension, with the result of individual crystals are more or less needle shaped, may display an excellent lineation. So hornblende shows excellent mineral lineation, and platy minerals also, some mica, that is biotite and muscovite, occur as elliptical plate, the long axis which are parallel, so lineation. Next, budinage. So what do you mean by budinage? When relatively strong layers, this is your bedding or strata here, so relatively small strong layer of rock becomes strength or an elongated during metamorphosis, they may separate into blocks separated by necks. So budin may be linear or chocolate or tablet shape. Here you can see by the apply of force, the beddings are first folded, then it is formed as a chocolate or tablet shape linear structure, that is called budin. And it is formed a thin layer, that one stronger and more important than the enclosing rocks. The line which joins, the line of junction between budins is called budin. Budins on which may be occupied by quartz and feldspar. This is your lineation and budin line, and this is formed by extension of linear structure. So here you can see in the field, this is your budding like lineation. Then type C is your infolded region. So infolded region, it may be linear or chocolate of extension, has occurred in both direction. Generally budinage occurs in stronger and competent rocks than the enclosing rocks. This is your incompetent or inner layer, this is your competent or stronger layer, outer layer. So budin occurs in the competent beds or outer layer in the folded region. So if this type of structure is seen, then it is called as infolded regions of budin. Next types is your roddings. It is a linear outcrop scale structure that is defined by penetrative array of parallel and highly elongated roddings of rocks. Quartz rods are found in, that is a quartz vein or quartz rods are found in some areas of metamorphosed rock. In their extreme development, they are long cylindrical rods of quartz. Quartz rods are small concordant veins of quartz and mainly found near the axial region of fold. These are formed due to leaching of silica and its segregation under stress. So these quartz rods, these are quartz rods due formed by the lineation, and this is called roddings. And these quartz rods in some metamorphic terrain, quartz veins occur in the forms of a cylindrical rock formed in pegmatitic stage. The next type is your bullion structure. This is a very distinctive structure associated with folded or cleaved and mod stone. The orientation of pencil structure, that is fine sediment, parallel and subparallel to fold axis. The actual expression of the structure is formed by sedimentary fissility and caught by penetrative axial plane, cleaved the intersection of two foliation sources to mullion in pencil. So this small structure is known as bullion structure, which is found in the folded mudstone or cleaved mudstone. So this is the types or types of lineation. Then what is the relation of lineation to the major structure? The lineation is systematic related to major structure are produced under similar condition of stress. So first, mineral lineation and major structure. So mineral lineation means lineation formed by mineral plate or flaky minerals. So the attitude from deformed pebble, oolites and grains of such mineral, grains of such as quartz are generally related with fold, associated with long axis of deformed pebbles which perpendicular to the fold axis. Next, intersection lineation and folding. A lineation produced due to bedding and axial plane cleavage is parallel to the fold axis. Here is the intersection lineation, and then crenulation lineation. Here is the crenulation lineation. If the bedding cleavage is thrown to minor crinkles, the axis of crinkles are likely to parallel to the major fold axis. Then budinage and folding. If the budinage is the result of stretching of a competent bend of limb of a fold, the bedding line is parallel to the fold axis. So roding structure of folding. Quartz roding is the parallel to the fold axis. Similarly, bullion structure parallel to the fold axis, as well as pencil structure is also parallel. So generally, lineation or all the structure of lineation parallel to the fold axis. Next, slicken side and folding. Slicken side creation on the fold plane indicates the direction of movement of featured planes. Then sedimentary fissility. Many sedimentary rocks are fine grained, tend to part parallel to strata, and thus they possess a process that is called bending. Bedding fold caused by plate on elongated graph lies on medium parallel to stratification. So this is all about lineation and its type and the relations between the major structure and lineation. Thank you.